So this October 2023, I did it again. I did Shirtober. This is where I design a t-shirt a day for every day in October. So 31 designs, all 31 different topics as well. And this year I did something special. I use Kittle. So I use Kittle templates to come up with each different design. In this video, I'm going to show you all the templates I used, all the designs I used, and I'm going to show you actually how easy it is to use Kittle templates and make a design. I'm going to do one for you in this video as well. Let's go. Hey everyone, it's Juno with Detour Shirts. In this video, we're going to talk about Shirtober, designing 31 t-shirts in 31 days and how easy it is to do in Kittle. Now, a lot of people talk about when they're on print on demand, should I go quality versus quantity? And actually, you should do both, and Kittle can help you do that because Kittle can make you do something that has high quality and really fast. So I'm going to show you both. That way you can have lots of quantity, lots of designs really quickly, and that's a way to really grow really fast on print on demand and test things out. Now, not everything's going to sell. I'm going to show you if these sell further down in the year, like I did with my previous Shirtober one. You can take a look at that video. I'll put it right here. And I showed you a year after how many sold. I'm going to do the same with this one. I just uploaded some of these to Amazon, so they don't get any sales right away, but I'm hoping to get some sales during Q4. So I'm gonna go first. I'm gonna show you all the templates, all the different topics that I use for Shirtober, and you can use these topics. I'll put them in a digital download. I'll put the link in the description as well. It's gonna be on my website. And you can use these topics. You can also use the old topics that I did for Shirtober. You just wanna try and test things out, try different niches, try different styles, and that's what I did with Kittle. I tried lots of different topics as well as lots of different styles that Kittle has on there. So I'll show you this, and then I'm gonna go on Kittle after that and show you how easy it is to go from template to final design in a matter of minutes. So here's the list I use. You can download again this list on my website, Shirtober 2023. I did one in 2022 as well as a Shirtober in April. I'll have all those three lists on my website. So first you can see we're gonna go through all of these. So the list is a little different from 2022 to 2023, but again, these are all different so that you can try out different niches, see which one works best for you, which style works best for you. So let's go down and I'll show you the different styles I use. So this one, first, Thanksgiving. You can see here, it didn't start with a Thanksgiving template. This Kittle template is more of a, looks like a hotel badge or whatever, but I used it for Thanksgiving. I just swapped out the middle, put in a gravy boat, and changed the text, and there you go, pretty simple. The next one is hockey. I did start off with a hockey one, but I changed it with this one right here. I changed up the text and everything. The only thing I kept was kind of that logo looking thing. I made it bigger and then the text is different, but underneath that font was the same, but pretty different. Here's one. I went from Taekwondo to Jiu-Jitsu. After posting this on social media, I'm now aware that Jiu-Jitsu doesn't do kicks like this, but at the time, this is what I did. So I could probably change this back to Taekwondo or something like that so it doesn't do Jiu-Jitsu, but you can see the change I made in this template. Here's one that's pretty similar to the template. All I did was change the graphic and the bottom, read more books instead of Happy Halloween. I think read more books, you know, could work a lot better and not have to have the 2023. Day five is s'mores. You can see I use this a vintage design, which I'm trying out, and I just swapped out the graphics to put some s'mores in here. Kittle has designs for everything, and it had some for s'mores as well. This one is flamingos. You can see I used a template that had lots of different ideas on it, not just sometimes you can find these on Kittle, is where they have multiple designs in one thing, and that's what I did. I took the flamingo from one place, and then the sunset from another, and text and fonts from another one too. Day seven, motorcycles. After uploading this, I realized that you can't use the Route 66. It got tagged, so I took that out and put a different one in there, and it was fine. So look at this. I love this design, and I also changed it from a white background to a dark background because I think dark shirts do a lot better. So this one was a ghost template, and I just changed the words and the ghosts, but I kept most of the other things. So this was a real easy template to final design. This one I really love. Look at this tiger. It's amazing on Kittle. I swapped out the text in the background, and I changed it to say tigers, tigers, tigers instead, and I think it turned out great. This one was a really simple change as well. Instead of Taste of Italy, I just changed it to say Have a Slice Day. I like that pun. And I added, the checkerboard, because I think a lot of times that's used in pizza box design and pizza design in general. Oh, and I also changed the color a little bit to just give it more contrast. Here's day 11, chameleons. Now this, again, is not a chameleon shirt, but I like the way, the vintage look of it, and chameleons change color, so I thought I would use a rainbow for that, and then you can see right here, color, 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 chameleon, which I thought was a nice pun too. And I think it turned out great. Snowboarding, I couldn't find a really good snowboarding template, so I made one from a bowling template. So you can use other templates to make something else. So don't always just look for, if you're doing a specific sport or a specific thing, you can look for templates that are for other things and then change it up. And of course, I reversed everything to use the red, white, and blue, mainly white for snow, but so that it stands out on a black t-shirt or dark t-shirt as well. So this one did start off as a chocolate template, and I changed the words and I changed the graphics, but most of the things stayed the same. Now this one turned really different. I didn't like this penguin, so I looked for kawaii penguins or really cute penguins, and I added the text below it with my homies, so it reads just chilling with my homies. Day 15, you can see this one isn't a template for unicorns, but it had rainbows, so that's what I was looking for. And I changed out some things and I made this the unicorn squad. Now there wasn't a lot of boba t-shirts, but they were coffee t-shirts. So I took a coffee design and changed it into a boba tea design, and I think it turned out great. So this one is day 17 for pickleball, and I know it says my design for aliens, which I made a mistake when I put this on social media. So just make pretend it says my design for pickleball. And instead of tennis rackets on this one, I swapped it out for pickleball rackets, and you can see I just changed the word, and I think I left a lot of the other things the same besides the text. This one also stayed really similar. I used it for aliens, and I changed the text and added kind of an alien cartoon sticker in the middle. Oh, and I also gave it a different texture. Day 19, cottagecore. There was a cottagecore template on Kittle, this one right here, but I wanted to make it work on black, so I changed the color up a little bit and I added more color with different flowers, took away the grass, and used the mushrooms instead. Day 20 for beach. I really like this Paradise Beach one. I wanted to see if I could use it, see if it would work on black. And it kind of works on black. I think it works really well on light. Having the white on black gives it a different look, kind of a negative look. I also learned that uploading this, I couldn't use Beach Life, so I switched it out to say California in the actual one, and that uploaded okay. Day 21 is ice cream. I really like this template where the words were in the ice cream, so I thought I'd try it out. And then to give it a little more width, I added a vintage sunset. So this one's pretty much stayed the same. I just swapped out the words, took out 2012 so that it can be used any year, any time of year, and I think it has a nice look to it. So for day 23, it was snakes, and I like this design for snakes, but I didn't want the words, so I took out the words and I added more flowers just to kind of tone it down a little bit. Day 24, I kept it really easy. This was a simple one. I just switched out the words basically and put this one right here, this banner, to the front so that I could read the full word. Day 25, I really like how this one had all the, like, the Statue of Liberty, Mount Rushmore, and other stuff. So I kept that, but I wanted it to have like more of a vintage feel. So I took America from another template and I put it right here. And I love how that mashup worked. And I wanted to fill this space, so I just brought in an eagle, which Kittle had, and I put it right there. Day 26, Santa. I like this one from Santa. In fact, I think I like this one better than what I have. But I took out the mug and I put Santa's face in here, and then I just changed the words. Day 27, anime. Kittle has a ton of anime stuff. This is one of them that I really like the layout of, and I wanted to change this to work on a dark t-shirt, and I did. And I just changed up the words. I actually added more words on the top and on the bottom to kind of space it out and kind of give it more height. Day 28 is beer. I found this beer template for St. Patrick's Day, but I wanted to make it more of an evergreen shirt, so I decided to do more kind of an American and music kind of thing that says country music and beer. That's why I'm here, and I think it could work for Q4 as well as throughout the year. So day 29, cruise. I really like how this one is, but I changed it up a lot so that I have more freedom so I can change the background. And I may have to show you how I did this one in another video because it is so different, but I like how it turned out. So day 30, Elf. I used this template with the penguins. You may have recognized these penguins that I used in the penguin design that I did, but instead of penguins on this time, I swapped it out and put elves in this and used the words elf squad. And lastly, day 31, and this was a very popular template on Kittle, and I swapped out, or I didn't swap everything out, I changed the words and I added a skier, but I also put this oval in here so that it can work with the skier on top of it. So those are all the 30 templates. Now I'm gonna go into Kittle and show you how easy it is, just a few minutes to go from template to design, and I'll use my first one with the gravy. All right, so here we are on Kittle. Now the first thing I would do in the gravy example is I was looking for a circle design, and you can just come in here on Kittle. You can see all these designs. You could start with any one of these, but I was looking for a circle, so I just typed in circle. And the reason like I want a circle is because it fits nicely on a t-shirt, really easy to work around with. And I thought, I couldn't think of what to do at first for gravy, so I thought, why not just put it in a circle like some of these other ones. And you can see there's a ton of them right here. And this one is the one I picked, but you could have picked any one of these. I think gravy would have worked on that one or that one or that one. So you can, you know, use any one of these. I'm gonna click on here and just say, use this design. So just that easy. And you can do this with any of the templates that you see. If you go back in the video and look at all those templates, go search for those, and this is how you start. So you find the template first. Next thing I would do is size it. So I'm gonna come in here. You can see it's 1200 by 1200 or what most of them are, but we're gonna need 4500 by 5400. So I just type in and make sure it's pixels, 4500 by 5400 pixels. Now some of them may be in inches, some of the templates may be in inches, but you can also change that right here from inches to pixels and hit confirm. And the nice thing about Kittle is you can just scale everything. So I'm going to do that and I'm going to just make it bigger like that. Boom. And I don't need this background here. So background color I can get rid of. I can also get rid of some of these other things. Looks like this is locked because it didn't scale with it. So I'm going to remove my face here. And this is what you can do if something is locked. Come in here, go to layers, look for something that's locked. There it is. Boom. Now I can click on it and delete it. Right? Cool. So now you can see nothing else is locked. I'm going to close this and I'm bring back my face. So next thing I want to do is change the words. So I just can come on here and you can do this with every Kittle design is all the text is editable. So I can come in here and say, gravy on everything. I got cap locks here, gravy on and everything. Do this one as well. Boom, that easy. Now I'm gonna remove these right here. I don't need that, and I don't need this. Boom, now it kind of looks like a donut, but I'm gonna put a gravy boat here. We're gonna just go into elements and do gravy. Now the one I used was this one. I'll just click on it and go like that. Boom. And the other thing I did was some gravy boat icons. So let's see. I think it was it this one? No, it was, pretty sure it was this one. So I'm gonna click on this and put it right here. And I can color this white. Boom. And I'm going to hold down option, drag it over here, and flip it. Right clicking, and it's going to play flip horizontal, and boom. And just move it into place. And I'm going to move this to the front, which you can do, just go like that. And there you go, gravy on everything. Now I did have some drips on here, so I'm gonna just look for drip. Yeah, and so you can, you know, if you want your gravy to drip a little bit, you can do that. Or I think there's some bigger ones, let's see, like this one here. like that. Oops, I don't think it was this one actually. Let's move this outside. I'll move it over there. And I'll move this here. Can turn it or that. And you can make this the same color as the gravy here. Look at that. Pretty cool, right? I don't think it was that trip. There you go, gravy on everything. I think that works really well. Now when you wanna export it, you don't have to remove the background on this. You can keep the background, but you can also see what it looks like on different color shirts. So like, what would it look like on a black shirt or a blue shirt or even a red shirt like this, right? And then to export, you do export, download this design, 4500 by 5400, click this remove background, optimize quality, hit PNG, and there you go, off to the races. Now, one thing I didn't do was put the texture on there, and I forgot to do that. So let me do that right now so you can see the difference. I can put this grunge texture on here, boom, and it clip the content and go here, alpha mask. Boom, there you go. Super simple, gravy on everything. Great for Thanksgiving. I think hopefully this will work for Thanksgiving, but you can change the words to whatever you want. It doesn't have to be gravy. It could be, you know, whatever your text you want here. I think it works really good on this circle, and Kittle has a ton of these, and you can see I did it in a matter of minutes. But there you go. You can see how easy it is to use Kittle templates and make a design. I did it really quickly, and you can see that they have a ton of templates. I used 31 of them to make 31 different designs, 31 different topics, and you can do the same on there. If you want me to do any more Kittle tutorials for any one of those, let me know in the comments which one of those templates or which one of those designs that I did in the 31 days, which one you want to see as a video. I can do one and make a video. I'll take a look at those comments. And if you want to see my other video for Shirtober last year, I'll put that on right up here so you can see all the different designs. I didn't use Kittle on that one, but I also did a lot of designs, so you can see how that one turned out and how many sales I got from last year. Thanks again for watching, and as always guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.